بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Today our talk will be about some of the abnormal presentations. We are going to start with what's described as a shoulder presentation, that is transverse lie or oblique lie. This is defined as the case in which the longitudinal axis of the fetus does not coincide with that of the mom. These are the most hazardous malpresentations because of the mechanical difficulties that occur during labor. The oblique lie, which is a deviation of the head or the breech to one iliac fossa, is less hazardous as correction to a longitudinal lie is more feasible. Instance, this happens to occur amongst 3 to 4% of women during the last quarter of pregnancy, but the incidence declines to about 0.5% by the time the labor commences. Etiology. Now, what are the causes or the factors which lead to such presentation, or I mean such malpresentation? Factors that change the shape of the pelvis, the uterus, or the fetus, or factors that allow free mobility of the fetus, or factors that may interfere with engagement. For example, these factors can be maternal or fetal. The maternal, for example, are contracted pelvis, laxity of the abdominal musculature, or uterine abnormalities as bicornuate uterus, subseptate uterus, and fibroid uterus. Also, this can be due to pelvic masses or such as ovarian tumors. The fetal causes may be multiple pregnancy, excessive amount of amniotic fluid, that is polyandriamnios, abnormal position of the placenta, placenta previa, prematurity, or intrauterine fetal death. The positions. In this malpresentation, the denominator is the scapula. And according to the scapular position, we define left scapulo-anterior, right scapulo-anterior, right scapulo-posterior, or left scapulo-posterior. The scapulo-anterior positions are more common than the scapulo-posterior because the concavity of the front of the fetus tends to fit with the convexity of the maternal spine. Diagnosis. This malpresentation can be diagnosed during pregnancy, or sometimes the diagnosis may be delayed to the time of onset of labor. During pregnancy, by inspection, you see that the abdomen is broader from side to side. By palpation, you find the fundal level lower than that which corresponds to the period of amenorrhea. And the fundal grip, the fundus feels empty. When you make the umbilical grip, the head is felt on one side while the breech on the other. In the transverse lie, they are at the same level, while on the oblique lie, one is higher than the other. The first pelvic grip shows that the uterine segment in the lower most part, the lower uterine segment is empty. By auscultation, the fetal heart sound are going to be best heard on one side of the umbilicus towards the fetal head. The ultrasound or the X-ray confirms the diagnosis and may identify the cause as multiple pregnancy or placenta previa. During labor, in addition to the previous findings, the vaginal examination will reveal the following. The presenting part will be high, the membranes are found to be bulging, and there may be premature rupture of membranes with prolapsed arm or cord. The dorsum of the supinated hand points to the fetal back and the thumb towards the head. The right hand of the shaped correctly by the right hand of the obstetrician and the left hand by the left one. When the cervix is sufficiently dilated, particularly after rupture of the membranes, the scapula, the acromion, the clavicle, the ribs, and the axilla of the fetus can be felt. Mechanism of labor. Actually, there is no mechanism of labor because there is a mechanical disadvantage. The transverse lie of the fetus intercepts the longitudinal lie of the mom, and so the labor process is obstructed. If the patient is left to progress in labor with a neglected or unrecognized transverse lie, one of the following may occur. Either impaction, that is the usual and the most common outcome, or the lower uterine segment gets thin and ultimately ruptures. The fetus becomes hyperflexed, the placental circulation is going to be impaired, the cord is prolapsed and compressed, leading to fetal asphyxia and death. Rarely, the fetal lie may be corrected by the splinting effect of the contracted uterine muscle so that the head presents. Spontaneous version, this is very rare, by similar process, the breech may become to present. Spontaneous expulsion, this is very rare, and it happens to occur if the fetus is small or dead or macerated. The spontaneous evolution, very rarely the head is retained above the pelvic brim, the neck greatly elongates, the breech descends followed by the trunk and the after coming head. That is spontaneous version inside the cavity. Management. How are we going to manage this case? It is either through external cephalic version, internal podalic version, or cesarean section according to the indication. The external cephalic version, this can be done in late pregnancy, that is between the 32nd and 35th week. It can be done even early in labor if the membranes are intact and the vaginal delivery is feasible. If version succeeds, apply abdominal binder and rupture the membrane and follow the uterine contractions. The second, that is the internal podalic version. This is mainly indicated in the second twin of the transverse lie, and it has to be followed by breech extraction. For internal podalic version to take place, there are prerequisites. There should be available general or epidural anesthesia. The cervix must be fully dilated, and the membranes are intact or just ruptured. Thirdly, cesarean section. This is the best and the safest method of management in nearly all cases that present in the transverse lie or oblique lie, even if the baby is dead. As the rupture of the membranes carries the risk of cord prolapse, an elective section is to be planned before labor starts. The neglected or impacted shoulder. The clinical picture of the impending rupture uterus. It is the pictures of exhaustion and maternal distress. The shoulder is going to be impacted, and maybe this is associated with prolapsed arm or cord. The membranes are ruptured since a time. The liquor amniae is drained. The uterus is tonically contracted. The fetus is severely distressed or dead. How to manage this case? Cesarean section is the first safest procedure, even if the baby is dead. A classical or low vertical cesarean section in the uterus facilitates the extraction of the fetus as breech, not by the head in such condition. Unstable lie. Unstable lie is defined as the case in which the fetus changes his lie frequently from transverse lie to oblique to longitudinal and so on. The etiology, any factor which is going to change the fetal-maternal mechanical correlation, that is, for example, polyhydramnios, prematurity or intrauterine fetal death, contracted pelvis, abnormal position of the placenta, tumors of the pelvis, multiparity with lax uterus and abdominal wall. Management. How are we going to manage this case? External cephalic version or even podalic version, This can be done whenever the woman is examined, but in the majority of cases, it will recur because of the factors that cause instability. The same factors are going to cause failure of the external cephalic version. After correcting the fetal lie to the longitudinal lie, we have to apply an abdominal binder and start an oxytocin infusion and do rupture of the amnion when the uterine contractions start and the presenting part is in the brim. The cesarean section is indicated in the following cases. Failure of the external cephalic version, or some actually do it electively in case discovered after 40 weeks gestation. Now we move to another type of malpresentation, that is cord presentation and cord prolapse. Definitions. In both conditions, there are loops of the cord that lie below the presenting part. The difference is that in the case of cord presentation, the membranes are still intact, while if these membranes get ruptured, then we are now facing a case of cord prolapse. يعني الاثنين مختلفين عن بعض فقط في حالة الـ fetal membranes. في حالة الـ fetal membranes, this is a case of presentation. لو الـ membranes ruptured, الـ umbilical cord هيتدلى خارج جسم الأم, and this will be a case of cord prolapse, which is totally different. Instance. This case happens to occur in one every 200 cases of labor. على الرغم انها ما هيش حالة ذائعة الشيوع, but you can describe it as not very rare. And it carries its significance not from the how much common this case happens to occur, but because of the risk. The risk. As long as the fetal membranes are still intact, there is no actual risk. The risk in this case will be that the membrane is going to rupture. Okay? In cord prolapse, the fetal perinatal mortality is very high. It ranges between 25 and 50% because of the asphyxia. The asphyxia happens to occur due to mechanical compression of the cord between the presenting part of the fetus and the bony pelvis of the mother, and because of the spasm of the cord vessels when exposed to cold or to manipulations. The prognosis gets worse when the cord is more liable for compression, as in the following cases. In the primary gravida more than in the multipara, in the cephalic more than in the breech presentation or the transverse lie. You can imagine this because the factor which is going to compress the prolapsed cord is the fetal head, which is harder than the breech. It's more hazardous when the cervix is partially dilated than when the cervix is fully dilated. It's clear why. It's more hazardous when there is a generally contracted than in the flat pelvis, and also in case of anterior than the posterior positions of the cord. The etiology of cord presentation or cord prolapse. This case happens to occur when the presenting part of the fetus is not properly fitting into the lower uterine segment, and this occurs due to either fetal causes or maternal causes. The fetal causes, for example, malpresentations as complete or footling breech, transverse and oblique lie, also in cases of prematurity, anencephaly, excessive amniotic fluid, that's polyhydramnios, twins or multiple pregnancy. The maternal causes include contraction of the maternal pelvis or the presence of pelvic tumors. These causes are predisposed by certain predisposing factors. For example, placenta previa, long umbilical cord, or cases of sudden rupture of the fetal membranes that happen to occur in polyhydramnios. Diagnosis. The case is diagnosed by vaginal examination. If the cord is prolapsed, it is a must to detect whether it is pulsating, that is, the fetus is living or not. Dead fetus, but this should be documented by auscultating the fetal heart sound. Ultrasound may help in the diagnosis, occasionally can diagnose cord presentation. Management. The management differs between cord presentation and cord prolapse. For cases of cord presentation, we do cesarean section for cases of contracted pelvis. In other conditions, the treatment will depend upon the degree of cervical dilatation. If the cervix is partially dilated, try to prevent rupture of the membrane as long as possible by putting the patient in the Trendelenburg position, by avoiding high enema, by avoiding repeated vaginal examination, and when the cervix gets fully dilated, manage as mentioned. Fully dilated cervix. In case of fully dilated cervix, the fetus should be delivered immediately by rupture of the fetal membranes and forceps delivery in engaged varicose presentation, by rupture of the fetal membrane and breech extraction in cases of breech presentation, by rupture of the fetal membrane together with internal podalic version together with breech extraction. This in case will be tried in cases of transverse lie. Otherwise, cesarean section will be indicated as well as for non-engaged vertex and other cephalic malpresentations. For cases of cord prolapse, the management will depend upon the fetal state. If the fetus is living and the cervix is partially dilated, then we have to do immediate cesarean section. Put the patient in that Trendelenburg position. Do manual displacement of the presenting part higher up. If the cord protrudes from the vulva, handle it gently and wrap it in a warm, moist pack. Give oxygen to the mother and do cesarean section. If the cervix is fully dilated, the fetus should be delivered immediately, as in case of cord presentation. If the fetus is dead, spontaneous delivery may be allowed. But cesarean section is the safest procedure if the case happens to be that the cause of the malpresentation and the prolapse of the cord is obstructed labor, as a destructive operation in this case will be obsolete. Now, let us move to another form of malpresentation, that is the compound presentation. Definition of compound presentation. It is a presentation in which there is prolapse of one or more of the fetal limbs along with the fetal head or the breech, both to enter the pelvis at the same time. Footling breech or shoulder presentation are not included in this group. Association with prolapse of the umbilical cord occurs in about 15 to 20% of these cases. And this what gives this type of compound presentation its importance, although it's not very common. Incidence of compound presentation. Easily detectable compound presentation occurs in around 1 every 500 to 1,000 confinements. If 1 every 500 to 1,000 deliveries. However, it's not possible to establish the exact instance. Why? Because spontaneous correction occurs frequently, and examination late in labor cannot accurately provide a diagnosis. Second, because minor degree of prolapse are detected only by early and careful vaginal examination. Classification of compound presentations. It's classified either cephalic presentation with or breech presentation with. Cephalic presentation with prolapse of either the upper limb, arm, hand, one or both, or the lower limb, leg, foot, one or both, or arm and leg together. Or the second division, breech presentation with prolapse of the hand or the arm. By far, the most common frequent combination is that of the fetal head with the hand or arm. In contrast, the head foot and the breech arm groups are not common. Prolapse of both hand and foot alongside the head is rare. All combinations, however, may be complicated by prolapse of the umbilical cord, which then becomes the major problem. The etiology of the compound presentation. The etiology of compound presentation includes all conditions that prevent the complete filling and the occlusion of the pelvic inlet by the presenting part. أي factor يقلل من احتمالية أو من فرصة إن الـ presenting part يملى الـ pelvic inlet هيدي فرصة لأن في جزء تاني من الـ fetal anatomy من الـ fetal parts هتبقى engaging itself مع الـ presenting part. The most common causal factor is prematurity. Other factors include a high presenting part with ruptured membranes, polyhydramnios, multiparity, contracted pelvis, pelvic masses, and multiple pregnancy. This condition is also more common with the inductions of labor involving floating presenting parts. يعني لما نعمل induction of labor وأثناء ما كده induction of labor يكون fetal parts floating أو presenting, ده هيدي فرصة أكتر لأن يحصل complex أو compound presentation. Another predisposing factor is the trials of external cephalic version. During the process of external cephalic version, a fetal limb, commonly the hand, the arm, but occasionally also the foot, can become trapped, tesher, before the fetal head, and thus become the presenting part when the labor starts. يعني ساعات ما بيبقاش original complex أو compound presentation بيبقى iatrogenic. وانت بتعمل external cephalic version ممكن تيجي الإيد أو الذراع يحشر كما يقال مع الهيد ويبقى presenting في أثناء الولادة. The diagnosis. Diagnosis is made by vaginal examination. And in many cases, the condition is not noted, unfortunately, until the labor is well advanced and the cervix is fully dilated. The condition has to be suspected when, يعني إمتى نخمنها أو نتوقعها. The condition is to be suspected when, واحد, if there is delay of the progress in the active phase of labor. اثنين, if the engagement fails to occur. ثلاثة, if the fetal head remains high and deviated from the midline during labor, especially after rupture of the fetal membranes. The prognosis. In the absence of complications and with conservative, careful management, the results should be no worse than with the other presentations. The mechanism of labor. As it might be obviously clear, the mechanism of labor is actually that of the main presenting part. Because the diameter is increased, the chance of this part to be arrested is increased. The management, as it is obviously clear, it is the management in accordance with the main presenting part. So if it is a breech, the case will be managed as breech presentation. If it is a shoulder presentation, the case will be managed as shoulder, and so on. Thank you.